This is CNN Breaking News.
That's right. We're going to begin with some breaking news. Donald Trump Jr. reportedly told in an email that the Russian government was trying to help the Trump campaign. This is CNN Tonight. I'm Don Lemon. Thanks so much for joining us. This is all according to the New York Times, which reports the email was sent to Trump Jr. by the man who set up his meeting more than a year ago at Trump Tower with a Russian lawyer. We're going to get straight to Maggie Haberman with the New York Times. She broke this story. She joins us now via phone. Maggie, just getting a hold of your reporting and reading some of it. So you have new reporting tonight about an email Donald Trump Jr. received. This is ahead of his June 2016 meeting with a Russian lawyer. What can you tell us about that?
So look, there's a lot that there's stuff we know, and there are many things we don't know. What we do know right now, and this was a very much a group effort at the Times by a lot of reporters, Don Jr., in the course of being approached about a meeting, and this is the Russian lawyer with whom he met, and these stories have been reported on over the last couple of days, that he received an email from an intermediary, and the email said, made clear that they, part of the point of this meeting was, to offer him some compromising information about Hillary Clinton, who at that point was clearly the nominee on the Democratic side. That the material was part of a larger Russian government effort to help his father's campaign. And the email was sent by Rob Goldstone, who was this person who Donald Trump had known for a few years. He was an acquaintance. That Donald Trump basically took it, essentially giving this guy a hearing. What we don't know is what the supposedly compromising information was. We don't know whether it was discussed at this meeting. We don't know what other correspondence there was, but we do know that there was, in writing, some statement that this information had come from a foreign adversary that was seeking to help Donald Trump become president. In typical campaigns, that would often be enough for a red flag. For the Trump campaign, which has operated and or did operate different than certainly any campaign I've ever covered, this was not. And Donald Trump Jr., who was known for having this very open door policy and meeting with almost anyone, didn't disdain this meeting and did not really think twice about it. What he has said publicly is that he did end up meeting with this woman, that she made some statements that made no sense, and then they somehow started talking about Russian adoptions, which really are a proxy for sanctions against Russia over human rights violations, but that he said he was not the right person to talk to. It because of the presence of this email, and Mr. Goldstone was not clear on how he knew this. He appeared to be, relaying information that he had heard from other people. It's not clear that he knew this firsthand, but it is clear that this information at best came with an asterisk.
Yeah. A couple questions for you. This email, do you think it'll ever come to light publicly?
I don't know, but at the rate we're going, it's certainly possible.
Okay. Let me read some of your reporting, Maggie. And again, this is the story, again, leading the New York Times tonight. Before arranging, this is from Maggie's reporting, before arranging a meeting with a Kremlin-connected Russian lawyer he believed would offer him compromising information about Hillary Clinton, Donald Trump Jr. was informed in an email that the material was part of a Russian government effort to aid his father's candidacy, according to three people with knowledge of the email. Mr. Goldstone's message, as described to the New York Times by the three people, indicates that the Russian government was the source of the potentially damaging information. It does not elaborate on the wider effort by Moscow to help the Trump campaign. There is no evidence to suggest that the promised damaging information was released to Russian government computer hacking that led to the release of thousands, the computer hacking that led to the release of thousands of Democratic National Committee emails. So the question is, when the email says this was part of the Russian government's attempt to aid his father's candidacy, does that indicate this wasn't just a one-off meeting, Maggie?
It could certainly, but again, I don't want to get further ahead than what the reporting actually is, and I want to be very clear about what we know and what we don't know. It could suggest that. There may have been. As far as we know, there was not. What we know is what is contained in this story, and what we know is contained in this email, but it does take it to a different level than what we knew it to be over the weekend.
Yeah. And since you said that, the email led to a face-to-face meeting with Jared Kushner, also with Paul Manafort, now we know Donald Trump Jr., and this lawyer, you know, this Russian lawyer. Does this give you any sense of how this was received in Trump world?
We don't have a broader sense at the moment of, you know, whether there was some bigger takeaway. You know, the people around the president have, and Don Jr. have said pretty emphatically that, you know, the president was not aware of this. That is actually entirely possible, given the way this campaign ran. You know, we only know what we know, which is that there was this meeting, that there was an approach that was made related to damaging information about Hillary Clinton that was advertised as having some kind of Russian government relation, and then that did not serve as a deterrent. Now, to be clear, this was a couple of days, this meeting took place, I think it was 4 or 5 days before it was widely reported that Russian government hackers had infiltrated the DNC servers. And this was many weeks before the John Podesta emails became an issue. So it's not really clear that this was on Don Jr.'s radar the same way. However, it was very clear that Russia was considered a foreign adversary by 2016, regardless of the emails.
In the reporting, it goes on to say the president was aggravated by the news of the meeting, according to one person close to him, less over the fact that it had happened and more because it was yet another story about Russia that had swamped the media cycle, meaning all of this, including his son, right?
Correct. I mean, he, as you'll notice, he used his Twitter feed to deflect information away from his son today. He talked about almost everything else this morning, the president on Twitter. and instead, you know, he focused on his daughter. He focused on James Comey. He focused on almost anything else. But he, you know, he came away, regardless of how, you know, critics or, you know, even some people close to the administration who support the president, regardless of how they perceived his interactions with Vladimir Putin during this Europe trip to the G20, the president felt really good about it, and his team felt really good about it, and they were deeply frustrated that, you know, that the Russia whack-a-mole popped up right at the tail end.
Maggie, I understand you have more reporting to do. We thank you for joining us here on CNN tonight.